guys do? Assemble?
Yeah, they like to assemble.
Left side down, yeah, just like that.
Stop with these two bolts in here.
They're motor mount bolts.
How many of these will I do a day?
About a thousand.
No, you wouldn't.
We do a thousand pairs of those a day.
Wow.
All day we're building. Three of them.
And then, once they...
Thank you.
Rules, the rest of it.
Rules.
Right, sorry. Carry on.
I'm sorry, let's speak a little louder. I can hear you.
Thank you. notice that in every room, all of the surfaces are smooth, so they're easily cleaned.
And these survive?
This is our kitchen, all complete on one wall. So you have a stone oven on the left hand side. You have a refrigeration system on your right hand side. The floors on the left side. And above this, all your cabinetry. The floor was a good proposal of a dishwasher on the side. Over here, you have your washer and your dryer.
But the house never went into production. $10 million was needed to get the venture going, and it could not be raised. Fuller tinkered with the design because the executives wanted him to simplify, but he refused to change some of the more innovative features. This impasse will continue for the company. The radical design, coupled with the new materials and methods for global living, posed difficult challenges. In the end, they fully get inside this response to the private event companies.
Thank you. show you. You can go there and see how thick the glass is.
So the tires are a little bit.
Here's the place to be, actually.
Thank you.
Here it is, folks. Welcome to the biggest, the best, simply the most amazing show ever to hit Springfield. For the first
May 20th, 1927, 4 a.m. If I could feel myself down on a bed, I'd be asleep in an instant. I pull the Spirit of St. Louis up 200 or 300 feet above the water, shake my head and body roughly, flex. I can't afford to relax. I must think about problems. What's the matter? The lights are rising. Too far apart from lights on the ship, I turn to the instruments. Yes, I've been flying with the right wing low. I must have been looking at some stars. I've lost command of my eyelids. I take it off my mouth, rub my head, hold that all on my head. The fuselage behind me becomes filled with ghostly presences, riding wheelless with in the play, and speaking with friendly human voices. Is that a call of our voices?
One thing is certain. There are no easy answers. Alternative methods of producing power, such as wind and solar, will deplete natural resources. But with current technology, they cannot generate large amounts of electricity in a reasonable cost. Others, like using the Earth's heat, can create environmental problems by bringing natural cultures to the surface. No future sources of energy raise more questions than for other choices.
ball. I was terrific. He didn't need it. You did what you were supposed to do with a ukulele. You played it beautifully. Congratulations.
Plays nice.
Yes, certainly does.
Plays nice too.
You gotta get a laugh while you're watching. Your kids are learning something, and they throw those little jokes in that the parents get to go over the kids' heads.
The plan is, he's asking the princess to lower her hair, and she's probably gonna let her hair down, and then the princess will climb up.
Thank you. three two locomotives in one. The fence and cylinders power six drive wheels. The back set of the stairs. Each set of wheels go to the
to this country that he loaned and be on display at the Smithsonian. But because of World War II, they didn't want a chance moving the plane that was in safe storage. So it didn't come back to this country until 1948.
In the safe storage,
you think? Yes. Well, tunnels. There was tunnels. They all lived in tunnels. Way down. So, the plane was dedicated on a significant date of history, December 17, 1948. 45 years to the day after that first flight. And it was dedicated by the old...
safety of our younger riders. We ask that the adults with them place themselves on the outside of the road. If that's not practical, please make sure they're held high at all times. Please refrain from smoking, eating, or drinking anything but water aboard the Wiser Railroad.
Bye.
And as we continue on now through Railroad Junction, we're about to pass the historic Smith's Creek Depot, which they built in 1858 in Smith's Creek, Michigan, about 8.5 miles southwest of Port Huron. Where as a boy, Thomas Edison worked for the Grand Trunk Railroad, selling treats and newspapers along the way from Port Huron to Detroit and back again. That brings us to the heart of our Railroad Junction district just up ahead, a Detroit, Toledo, and Milwaukee roundhouse, where we repair and maintain our three coal-fired steam locomotives. Originally built in 1884 in Marshall, Michigan, it was recreated here at Greenville Village in the year 2000. Using elements from the original building. So stop in, get a bird's eye view of all the work going on the shop floor, and one of the nation's last remaining operating roundhouses. And that brings us to our Liberty Craft Works District, where you'll find artisans and craftsmen creating beautiful objects in glass and pottery, tin and weaving. Plus, there's the Liberty Craft Works store, where you can take home a few of these beautiful items for yourself.
I'm
rounding up a neglect of most of the yellow buildings, is Sarah Jordan boarding house where Edison staff used to live. It's the first residential structure in the U.S. to be lighted up for electric light. Please stay seated till you hear that whistle blow.
We're down for a little bit.